In this screencast, we'll take a look at how we can analyze information about a process and use it to determine a transfer function. So in the problem statement that's provided, we have that a temperature control loop has been designed for a particular process. And the goal here is to develop a control loop which provides a 1/6 decay ratio and something that will provide no offset. The operators tested this by making an instantaneous change in the temperature of the input. And when doing this, they got the lack of an offset, and they got the 1/6 decay ratio. They also found the period of oscillation was 10 minutes. So based on this information, we're being asked to A, find a second order transfer function for the process, B, determine the maximum temperature that occurs, and C, when that maximum temperature occurs. If we're looking for a second-order transfer function, then what we can do is go into the generic form of the transfer function, which is k over tau squared s squared plus 2 zeta tau s plus 1. They note a 1/6 decay ratio. With a 1/6 decay ratio, that is telling us that the transfer function oscillates, but also has decaying oscillations. And for a second-order transfer function, that is consistent with an underdamped process. Additionally, we see that there's no difference between the set point and the measured value of the temperature. So therefore, that tells us that T actual at the end will equal T set point. What we also see here is that since we have an instantaneous change of 3 degrees, this tells us that this is a step input with the magnitude of 3 degrees. And we're also told that the period of oscillation is 10 minutes. So therefore, we have a few variables of interest which we can get from a second order underdamped response. So for a step function, the graph for an underdamped response looks as such. What we're now going to do is relate this graph to the data provided in the problem statement. So what we have here is that the system began at a particular temperature, so we'll call that TSS, the steady state temperature, and then there was a step increase of 3 degrees. Therefore, our M here is 3, because that's the magnitude of the step input. The period, the time here, is given as 10 minutes, and we know that the decay ratio, which we can get from here, which is C over B, that equals 1 over 6. The question is asking us to find the transfer function. So in other words, we have to use this information to back out k, zeta, and tau. And it's asking us to determine the maximum temperature, which we know happens at the first peak, and the time it takes to reach this first peak right here. So we'll start by finding the second order transfer function. And to do that, we can take advantage of the fact that the decay ratio and the period of oscillation both have formulas which are functions of zeta and tau. So if we put those down, we see the k ratio formula is the exponential of negative 2 pi zeta over the square root of 1 minus zeta squared. This equation here is a function of zeta only. So we can solve for the decay ratio and immediately get zeta. If we look at the period equation, T, which we'll here represent as the magnitude of the period, equals 2 pi tau over the square root of 1 minus zeta squared. And this is a function of zeta and tau. But fortunately, we can solve the decay ratio equation first to get zeta, and then use the period equation to find tau. So for the decay ratio formula, we'll have that 1/6 equals the exponential. And when the math is done for this, we can solve and see that zeta is 0.274. We can do the same thing for the period of oscillation, which is given as 10 equals 2 pi tau over the square root of 1 minus zeta squared. And we can substitute in zeta. And when we do this and solve for tau, we find that tau is 1.53 minutes. So we can now substitute into the transfer function definition. So before we substitute this out, what we now want to do is think about what does k equal? The definition of k would be delta output over delta input. And what we saw was we made a 3-degree change in the input. And if the process had no offset between what the temperature should be and what it actually is, then that indicates that this delta output is also 3 degrees. So therefore, our gain here is just 1. So if we substitute in and multiply out our values here, we end up with our final transfer function. Parts B and C are asking for the max temperature and the corresponding time. So if we go back to our graph, what we can do is recall the fact that we're looking for these two values indicated in blue and now being recircled in green. And we can take advantage of a couple equations. We can take advantage of the overshoot equation, because the overshoot is a representation of how much the value goes over. And we can use the equation for time to the first peak, which is time where the maximum peak is. So these formulas are both functions of tau and or zeta. We can use the values that we just found for zeta and tau to find those two parameters. So when we do that, an overshoot is defined as B over A, which is equivalent to the exponential of negative pi zeta over the square root of 1 minus zeta squared. So again, this is only a function of zeta. So if we substitute the zeta in here, we can find the fact that the overshoot is 0.41. If we look back at our figure, we can see that B represents how much the peak exceeds the steady state of 3, and A is the difference between the original value and the new steady state. So we know that the value of A, the distance between the starting point and the final point, is 3 degrees. And for B, that will be our maximum temperature minus the change in temperature, which, as we know, was 3. So T max minus 3 degrees equals 0.41. T max is 4.23 degrees above the original temperature. Finally, to find the time to the first peak, often represented as Tp, this equation is just pi tau over the square root of 1 minus zeta squared, which is also very closely related to, if we look above, very close to the definition of the period. It's only half of the period equation. So without doing all the calculations, we can easily say that this is half of the period, which we found earlier to be 10 minutes. So therefore, the time it will take to see the maximum temperature, which is 4.23 degrees above the original temperature, will occur at 5 minutes. So in this screencast, we took advantage of our knowledge of landmarks of underdamped second-order functions, and we use them to calculate the transfer function and find other important information about the process response.